All right, let's do this thing right here. We've got Sig Sauer. I've been waiting a long time to get this package in. And do you know what Sig Sauer this is? No, it's not a pew-pew. This is the Sig Sauer Zulu6 image stabilized binoculars in 16 by 42 millimeter HD series. I've been on a optics kick lately, and this is image stabilized. We're going to add it to our collection, and we're going to take it out in the field and we're going to test it. But let's unbox it first and see what we have. All right. Top it off with the caution. Do not use manganese battery. Okay, I'll be sure not to. I'll use lithiums instead. How about some lithium energizers? I think these are AA batteries that this Sig Sauer uses. I'll just put in some energizer lithium batteries in there and it'll stay a long time. All right, quick reference guide. We're going to put that aside. We see the package. Okay, not bad. We've got a nice case. I'm feeling Cordura. I'm feeling a lot of padding. Both of those are good signs. Belt loop. Okay. Velcro. I do like magnetic more than I like Velcro. This just makes too much noise in the field. Especially if you're trying to remain quiet, you've got animals that you don't want to scare off, or people that you don't want to alert to your presence, Velcro is not the way to go. Magnetic is. But they gave us Velcro. I'll take it. All right. Let's bring this out. You know, the reason why image stabilized binoculars are so great, especially in these higher powers, and like I said, this one is 16x, is because your hand shakes, right? No matter what you do out in the field, your hand is going to shake, especially at higher magnifications. And that's when something like this is an absolute beautiful piece of equipment for your rig, because you can carry this around, have immense magnification. I mean, 16 is nothing to joke about. 16x is more than I have ever used out in the field. My greatest non-image stabilized unit is Biathlon, and it was a 12 by 50. And I had a very tough time holding that thing straight and still. And if you cannot hold it straight and still, and everything, including your heartbeat, makes your hands quiver just a tad, you may not even see it with the naked eye, but there is a certain amount of minute trembling happening when you hold anything. Now, see what happened? That eyepiece cover just popped right off. So, I am liking this. This does not weigh very much at all. 16 power. Let's get a close up here. China, of course. Sig Sauer. Zulu 6. 16 by 42. So 16 magnification is high. Not as high as my Canon image stabilized, which I'll do a review on later. That one is 18 by 50. But this is definitely a very high powered unit. 16 by 42. What does that 42 mean? Well, that's the diameter one edge to the other, just this distance right here, 42 millimeters diameter, okay? Diameter, 42 millimeters. What does that get you? Well, 42 millimeters is generally what people go to for bird watching and things. And the reason that they do is it gives ample light gathering capacity at night. So you can gather up light at twilight or early sunrise hours and be able to make out what you're actually seeing. The eye covers themselves, this is plastic, okay? So I don't expect much from eye covers, but I do think that perhaps they could have put in, instead of individual eye pieces for the exit pupil, this is the exit pupil. I wish they would have had a longer one-piece unit that would have been easily attached, right? That would have been better. But I am impressed by the weight of this unit. And I'll do a full spec on it later on, but that's impressive. It's a very impressive weight, much lighter than what I had anticipated when I ordered this unit. I wonder if the box has any information on the bottom of it. Strap. We'll put that aside. It does. So, electro-optics technology, OIS, proprietary OIS, Sig optic stabilizer system, is gyroscopically stabilized to cancel out unwanted shaking and vibration that can blur an image, especially at higher magnifications. That is what we were talking about, right? So even at 12 by 50, your hand is going to shake. And my personal belief is that anything above 10x, 10 power magnification, your hand is going to shake and your image needs to be stabilized by either bringing your elbows onto a table or perhaps using a tripod. But then there's the weight of the tripod itself, right? Well, the whole reason that I got this was to do away with the use of the tripod out in the field. What else do we have? MOTAC. Activated through motion sensing technology, MOTAC immediately powers up illumination when it senses motion and powers down when it does not in order to extend battery life. Very nice. And from what I read and from what I see others in reviewing the battery life of this particular unit, you're talking about a season of hunting and you don't need to change the battery. There was one person who was talking about a year that he has gone on using it for various hunts throughout the season and having changed the battery only one time. So, good stuff there. Spectra coat. This is important. Ultra-wide broadband anti-reflective lens coating for superior light transmission across the entire visual spectrum. That's always a good thing. Lens armor. This is also important to me. Abrasion-resistant lens coating for extreme durability. I like that. Lens shield, proprietary mil-spec, oleophobic, I guess. I don't know what that means. I think that's probably oil and other liquids. Coating that sheds water, oil, and gunk to ensure a clean sight image at all times. Excellent. And this is the number one thing about Sig. Warranty. Infinite guarantee. 6-hour electric Electro-optics are guaranteed forever. Unlimited lifetime guarantee, fully transferable. No warranty card or receipt required. No time limit applies. Now, I have heard that Sig has the electronics on this thing is warranted supposedly for 5 years, but the optics are lifetime. But I am sure to enhance goodwill for the Sig Sauer brand that they will listen to whatever a customer has to say about why their unit doesn't work after that 5 year mark. I don't know that for sure, but the way that Sig Sauer as a company generally works, and in order to enhance goodwill with the community, I'm sure that they will listen. But I have read 5 years on the electronics of this unit, but the optics, lifetime, no questions asked. We took out briefly this little strap to strap on. Let's see the quality of this. Okay. Nice. Neoprene. Sig emblem. Sig Sauer. And this is not lasered on the Cordura part of this strap. That's actually stitching. High quality. Good. And the attachment point is quick release. Very nice. Okay. So there you have it. That's a quick unboxing of the Sig Sauer Zulu 6. Let's take a look at this package again. Image stabilized binoculars in 16 by 42. This unit, or this Zulu 6 unit, does come in a 10x magnification as opposed to 16x. I chose the 16x. The reason being, I think that in hunting as well as long distance viewing, I get value from 12x and above. And remember what I was saying about 12x as my personal limit for being able to hold it steadily? Actually, 10x being my personal limit for being able to hold a pair of binoculars steadily? Well, 16, this is definitely, for me, not something that I would handhold and be able to hold steady. So using stabilization gyroscopically, electronically within the unit, that is something that I think will benefit me and my endeavors. Let's look at the eye cups. Yeah, okay. So they extend and there are detents. So that's baseline 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a soft detent, but a detent nonetheless. That last one doesn't have a detent. Nice. The battery compartment is right here. AA battery. You can get it off the shelf anywhere. That's a plus for sure. What does this little lever do? Oh, on and off. Very good. Written on the unit, image OIS, optical image stabilization, Sig Sauer. So we'll put a battery in it, take it out in the field, use it for a little bit, and then I'll be back and telling you my thoughts on the Sig Sauer Zulu 6. Thanks for watching, folks.